All right, so here is an SR NOR latch, and it functions very similar to the one that we just saw, but it's built a little differently. You'll notice that it uses one fewer gate, and the gate that it does use is the NOR gate, so the not of the OR, which is actually kind of nice because this is one of our universal gates, and that's kind of nice because it means that we could potentially build all of our memory using the exact same gate. Okay, so it's worth thinking about this a little bit. I'm not going to spend a ton of time on this video. This is probably one of the places where loading something into Logisim and playing around with it is going to help a lot. But basically, the behavior is nearly the same as our AND OR latch. So you know, if we turn on S, this is so this the NOR is basically on only when both of its inputs are off, right? So once this signal turns on, we know that it doesn't matter what this signal is, this output is going to be off. And what's interesting here is that this is both one of the outputs of the circuit and an input to another part of the circuit. So that zero will propagate over to one of the outputs, and it will also propagate over to the input of this other part of the circuit. Now that we know that both of these are off, we know that this one is on, which is going to activate this output, and then the one there is also going to propagate here, which isn't going to change this output. And so now you can see that we get a one in the output for Q, and this is this is similar to what happened with the last circuit. So we turn on the set bit, and the output turns on. And it turns out that in general, the behavior is similar to the last time. So if we were to turn off this S, this Q would stay on, the Q prime would stay off. And then if we turned on R, this would become zero and this would become one. So the Q prime is sort of an opposite of Q in some sense. So it is worth thinking a little bit here about what would happen if we turn both R and S on at the same time. So in the last latch, this didn't really lead to anything weird. It just, we had this sort of property where the R kind of overrode the S. So it's worth thinking about this for a second. So to pause the video and see if you can think about what would happen in this case if we turn both R and S on at the same time. So if you think about this, the situation becomes a little bit weird, because if we were to turn this on, that means that this would turn off, which means that we would have both Q and Q prime, or what we generally think of as not Q, as both being zero, which is strange. We really shouldn't have Q and not Q both being zero. And so for that reason, we generally disallow having both the set and the reset bit on at the same time, because then we get to a situation that seems self-contradictory. And in fact, the situation is even worse than this, because if we start at this position and then we turn both R and S off simultaneously, then we get into some real trouble. It's worth thinking for a second about what's going to happen. So maybe pause the video and think about that. So it turns out that if we turn both of these signals off at the same time, then both of the outputs of the NOR are going to turn on simultaneously. Both of those are going to propagate into the other NOR gate, which is going to turn off the other NOR gate. So then the zeros coming out are going to propagate back around, and it's going to turn back on. And so basically, we're basically just going to get these values oscillating back and forth. And this circuit now will become unstable, and it'll just keep going back and forth as quickly as possible. Every time that the gate changes, this generates, this uses electricity, it generates heat, and it will eventually melt the connection, possibly cause a spark on the circuit board, and it will certainly destroy the circuit. And so that's not a good outcome. All right, so that was one kind of latch. Another kind of latch that you'll explore more thoroughly in the lab is something called a D-latch. And this is the latch that you may remember if you read the code book that I recommended over the summer. So we think about the S as being the save that bit. And as long as S is on, Q will change to reflect the value of D once S turns off, Q is frozen and retains its previous value. And so this actually has the property of being a little bit easier to reason about than the SR latch. And so it's useful for that reason.